Guys, gather around. OG Silverback here. And today I have a tale of victory and a tale of glory where a few strong men stood up against the hordes of gynocentrism that looked to destroy us. Hey guys, I was watching on the internet, they had a streaming of the 2018 Mr. Olympia. And so this guy, Shawn Rhoden, won it, man. And there's been a lot of talk about, is he a one-hit wonder? Or did he win it because he won it in default? Or he won it in forfeit, you know, because Phil Heath like had some problem with his stomach where he needed a hernia surgery. And that had his stomach extended. And, you know, in bodybuilding, it's all about the illusion of having the perfect physique, right? And I say it's an illusion because, you know, it's the lighting and also the way they posture themselves and this and that. And so, you guys out there, like you incels and TFLs and PUAs and MGTOWs might be saying, like, OG Silverback, what's that got to do with picking up women? What's that got to do with being successful in life? What's that got to do with anything, man, getting better with women and dominating women? I said, well, it has a lot to do with it because, as always, guys, I put a music video at the beginning of my audio that is appropriate, and it's called A Teachable Moment. And I put the link for this song here, this music video, and it's actually the official video for a group called Queen, and it's called We Are the Champions, dude. And man, I gotta tell you something, man, that song brings puts chills in my spine, because I was a kid growing up, dude. they used to make us listen to that, man. We used to do, like, you know, football drills or basketball drills or just running or working out, man. They would blast it in the stadium, man. Or they blast it in the gym. Just hearing that song gets me pumped up because what I've asked you guys to do repeatedly, and hopefully it's sinking in, but even before you listen to my video, just go and click the link on the music video. I mean, I think of music videos are very entertaining. They tell a story. And I utilize the script that the producers and the writers have written to help to drive home a point, because most guys are visual type of individuals. So me talking, yeah, is cool and everything, and you might feel connected, but when you see it in pictures, it touches a different part of your mind. So if you can watch the music video, and he can say how he's persevered, he kept on fighting to the end. And this is my personal opinion about Shawn Rhoden and tenacity. Like, I put some video links in here to show Shawn Rhoden going from bodybuilding from when he was a teenager all the way up to now. And he won the Mr. Olympia 2018 at 43. So they saying that I think he's the oldest guy to ever win the Mr. Olympia, because, you know, Arnold won it when he was like in his 20s, right? And other people like, you know, Jay Cutler and Phil Heath and all those guys, you know, it's a young guy's sport because of just what you have to put your body through. But what I like about Shawn Rhoden, man, and in my opinion, I'm gonna give you my honest opinion here, you know, because there's some video links in here that are saying that, you know, bodybuilding's fixed or Mr. Olympia's fixed and it's political. And yeah, I agree to that to a certain extent. I think it comes down to a business of what is the most marketable for the IFBB, the International Federation of Bodybuilders. And I just want to share this with you because, you know, as a businessman, I try to impart this upon you TFLs and incels and MGTOW guys and PUAs and MRAs and law guys. Law stands for life after women, not law like legal. I'm not giving any legal advice. And I should give disclaimers on my videos. I'm going to give one now. Anyone listening to this video, you're responsible for your own behaviors and actions. I'm just letting you know what I've done in the past. And it's an entertaining story. It's for comedy only. There you go. So I've lived up to that. So I think the whole thing, like what I tried to impart upon you guys, is what I've come to understand is the key to this whole game of self-esteem, self-worth, inner game, being good with women, being good with men, just being confident in life. Let's get your financials in order, man. Because once I got my financials in order, everything else fell in place, man. And that was like the Shawn Rhoden story, you know, it was tenacity and not giving up, because it's not always going to be easy. And so with Shawn Rhoden, man, when I think about him, I think about the reason I got out of the cage fighting, man. And I'm going to tell you why. So what happened is when I first started doing martial arts, I started out doing Taekwondo because that's a little kid's martial arts. Nothing against you Taekwondo dudes that compete at the world championship level. I'm just speaking as a fighter, as my own personal preference. It's like the whole thing about martial arts, guys, it's like religion. We all have a right to our own beliefs, man. Like, I don't believe there's, you know, honestly, man, not to get too political because they say you shouldn't talk about politics or religion, but I don't believe there's one true religion, dude, because, I mean, it's just too much for me to handle because when I was incarcerated, man, they called me the monk, dude, and this is all I did. True story, man. I got all the holy books that they had in the prison, so I got the Christian Bible. Just so you know, there's five different versions of the Christian Bible, man, and then I got the Catholic Bible, and then I got the Jewish Bible, and then I got the Quran, of course, and then I got the Satanist Bible, and then I got the Hindu Bible, and I got the Buddhist Bible, right? And the Confucianism, I studied that as well as reincarnation, and I studied Scientology. And one thing that I found, man, in all of these holy books, guys, is there's a concept in there that do right unto others as you would have them do unto you, so that the higher powers, whatever you believe in, will then look favorably upon you in the next life, whatever that may be, depending upon your belief, right? And then there's stories of consequences when you don't do so. And so there's a common theme, because a lot of the prophets, man, have the same experience, man, but they have it with gods of different names, you know. There's also a Holy Mother in all of it, you know what I mean? As above, so below, all this stuff. So I just come to find that, you know, because I used to go to all the different religious services, because at level 4, that's the only way you get out of your cell. You either get to go out to eat, go out to work, go out to the yard, or you go into a visit, or you go into a religious service. Otherwise, you're locked down, dude. We got violent criminals. So I had claustrophobia, guys. I didn't find it out until I went in there. But, yeah, so I did the same thing with martial arts. I took Taekwondo, man, as a little kid, and I got really good at it until I ran into a dude that can box really good, man. And, no, that's not what happened. So what happened was I ran into a dude who, he could wrestle, man. Yeah, so when I threw a high Taekwondo kick, he went under it. And then he came in too close to me, and I didn't know what really to do with my arms, because Taekwondo is more of a like kicking sport. And it's called an upjack. He upjacked me and hit the ground. Luckily for me, I was strong, but then I ran into some guys who were like, dude, like, boxing, man, is really good, because when they come in to grab you, if they get past your kicks, so I took up boxing. And then later on, I got into wrestling. But the point I'm making is I've taken all these different martial arts. It was really good because when you competed, you did one specific thing. So when I did Taekwondo, I did that. When I did karate, I did that. When I wrestled, when I boxed, right? Like that. But then when cage fighting came out, guys, I quickly found out that, you know, I could be champion one day. But then the next day, like, say the cage got some sweat on the ground or some blood, and I slip at the same time that the dude is punching me, and it looks like he knocked me down, he's going to score some points. And maybe I do hit the ground hard because I slip as I'm trying to evade his punch, you know. And then it's just those little nuances and just the, with the randomness of it, that I just decided, man, after my fifth cage fight, man, I decided that was it, because it was like, all the guys there train at such a level that they're all champions, and your ranking is interchangeable based upon the situations of that day, you know what I mean? And I don't know if I'm explaining it properly, but when I look at Shawn Rhoden, man, and Mr. Olympia, and I look at the one video that I put the link in, I mean, the dude's been doing this for a while, man, and he's come, you know, he's persevered, he's won a lot of shows, you know, as amateur, of course, and he turned professional. And then he reminds me a lot of Ronnie Coleman because for years, you know, Ronnie Coleman was like nobody even knew who he was. Like he was a pro, but he's coming like 13th place and 11th place and 8th place. Like nobody really knew who he was or gave a shit. And then there's a story that he talked to Flex Wheeler and learned the secret sauce. And then he became Mr. Olympia. But then when you look at Shawn Rhoden, I'm going to tell you what I like about Shawn Rhoden. And while I feel that, you know, he's not a one-hit wonder. That's why I'm making this video. People are saying, oh, he's a one-hit wonder because, you know, Phil Heath had the problem with his hernia in his stomach and, you know, this and that. But, and then Kai Greene wasn't there, right? And so then the whole thing, but William Bonet was there and then Rolly Winkler was there. And, you know, I'm not going to say anything derogatory against Dexter Jackson, but I think age is catching up with him. He reminds me of Vince Taylor. There was this dude named Vince Taylor. Like I met him when I was stationed in Germany. I met him and Mike Christian. I met Tom Platz. I met Dr. Fett, Fred Hatfield. Like Germany was just a hotbed for professional bodybuilders coming through. But I remember Vince Taylor, man. His physique was like, dude, his physique was phenomenal, bro. And he almost won the Olympia many times, dude. And then when they came out with the Masters Olympia, he smashed that dude. I think he won more Master Olympiads than anybody. But the dude's physique was like, whew, dude, it was next level, man. And this was back in the fucking 80s, bro. So anyway, Shawn Rhoden reminds me of Ronnie Coleman in the fact that Ronnie just kept sticking at it and eating and dieting and training and taking the supplements and believing in himself. And sometimes, you know, like I said in my videos, the real truth about steroids, dude, like, dude, there's a thing called tenacity. And sometimes you got to pay your dues. Like, you got to just keep training and training. And it looks like your muscles aren't getting bigger. And it's because what you're getting is called muscle maturity and density. Like, the muscles are packed in. Because this is how I look at bodybuilding. And it works for me in my own head. You guys got to come up with your own thing. Because I read Arnold's book, The Education of a Bodybuilder. And Arnold said when he was doing curls, he would imagine his muscles, his biceps inflating like mountains. And they just develop into mountain peaks. And if you look at Arnold's arms, man, he had mountain peaks on there. And I had the same thing, man. When I had the biggest arms I ever got, I had 23.5-inch arms, man. And that was just my genetic limit. They couldn't get any bigger. And, you know, you're talking about having big arms and being lean, too. And I used to just imagine in my arms whenever I did an exercise, bro, and I felt the burn and the pain, I imagined that it was like there was an air machine stuck to my body and it was pumping air into my muscles. So the way I looked at bodybuilding was when I did bodybuilding preparing for a show, I'm like inflating my muscles. And I looked at it like inflating it with blood, you know, the pump. I was big on the pump. And then in the off season when I did powerlifting, I looked at packing on like slabs of clay. I looked at that like packing in, you know how you inflate an area? So I looked like taking a balloon and packing mud inside of it to make it dense, to give it more of a foundation so the next time I go to pump it up. Because I did cycling, you know, like in the off season I did a lot of heavy lifting. Like I was doing sets of like 5-3-1-1-1, like that, singles, triples, and, you know, five. So I would come to the gym and I'd do like 15 reps to warm up, and then I'd do 10, would add some more weight, and then I'd do five, and then I'd do three, and then I would do three sets of singles. And then I'd move on to another exercise because the way we were taught is you get strong to get big. So in the off season I did that for about, 6 months, and then in 3 months I'd have what was called a transitional period. So I would go from the 15-10-5-3-3-1. I would go more into like a 20-15, and then my sets would be between 10 and 6. I wouldn't go if the weight was set so heavy. If I couldn't do 6 reps, I would lighten up because I wanted my rep range to be between 10 and 6. And that for me was a transitional period. So then the 3 months before a bodybuilding show, I would do 25, 20, and I would do all my sets 15 to 10 reps. So anything, I wouldn't go below 10 reps. And so if the weight was heavy enough where I couldn't do 10 reps, I would lighten it up. and that would decrease my rest periods. And I started doing like a lot of supersets, man. But I'll make a video on that. But the whole thing I'm saying is, you know, by cycling my workouts like that, my muscles continuously grew. And I see a lot of guys now, they don't really cycle their workouts. That's why I encourage guys to compete in bodybuilding competitions and powerlifting competitions, because it gives you a chance to see the effects that different training regimes do on your body. Because when you train the same way all the time, even if you have a routine that works good, you become stagnant, bro, because your muscle is called homeostasis. Like, your body gets adapted to that, and you no longer get the appropriate stimulus. That's why I believe in switching your workouts up every 3 months. It's called cycling, periodization. But a lot of guys don't get into the scientific aspect. But so anyway, what I liked about Shawn Rhoden, man, is he just continued to train and believe in himself. And Shawn Rhoden is tall, man. Like, when you look at him for a bodybuilder, he's tall. So as me and Lou Ferrigno and Arnold knew, and Rolf Mueller, it's hard to really pack on muscle and a tall physique to compare to a little dude, a shorter dude's physique. So you got to really be patient. But he kept to his game plan. And I think what happened is, in the years prior to Shawn Rhoden winning this year, I think, you know, I can't speak for him, but I think he was playing another man's game because he was trying to pack on the size. Because Phil Heath is a pretty formidable guy, and then Rolly Winkler, and then Big Rami, right? And I think that when you try to play another guy's game, you lose, because I think that's how Frank Zane beat Arnold, like, in the 60s, Frank Zane used to just try to get bigger and bigger and bigger, but he was a small frame guy. But when he went more for quality, he blew the giants away, you know what I mean? He just had they call it a classic physique, like the ancient Grecian physique. And he was beautiful, man. And so that was his specialty right there. And I think Sean Ray followed that same kind of philosophy, you know, along with Barry DeMay and John Brown, you know, guys like that. Because you can't always play the size game, bro. You lose your aesthetic beauty. And so I think that Shawn Rhoden started trying to play the size game, and that's when he started. I don't know if you guys remember, but for a few years there, everybody had the extended guts, man. So that's why Phil Heath was able to get away with it, because not only did he have it, but everybody else had it, because they used to comment on everybody. Even said Shawn Rhoden had an extended gut, right? And that's because when you eat all that food, man, like, people don't understand. That's what I tell you guys in my video, The Real Truth About Steroids. I encourage you to watch that series that I have. But dude, to get bigger, like, even if you're on drugs, bro, to get bigger, you got to eat more food, man, because you are what you eat. And so then how are you going to pack muscle on if you're not bringing in the calories, right? And it's got to be good, high quality, clean food, right? So you got to eat a lot, man. You know, I remember when I got up to like 340, bro, I used to eat every fucking hour, bro. And sometimes I'd be eating, I'd throw up because the food I ate just an hour ago wasn't really fucking digested. But, you know, when I was competing against, like, the steroid monsters, I didn't have a choice. I was like, I had to find another way. And I found this program that, I forget the name. I think it was called Universal. It was Universal. They had a bodybuilding program. And it says, like, for to pack on mass fast, you know, you would eat for every hour. You did that for like a month, and then when you go back to eating like every 2 hours, then you back it off to every 3 hours and every 4 hours, and then you cycle back up and you shock your body. And these are some gems I'm giving you guys, bro, just letting you know the plethora of knowledge I have. And so I think when Shawn Rhoden was trying to play the size game, that's when his belly got extended. And I think it's good that he got with that guy, Chris. Because he's well known. His wife, just so you know, Chris got a wife named Laura, man, and she used to be a national level bodybuilder. I think she was almost Miss Olympia, and I'd like to see what she looks like now, because she was awesome back in the day. And so anyway, Chris told him, like, dude, play your own game, like, just come in the best Shawn Rhoden you can. And that's the moral to this video, guys. Like, Shawn Rhoden just brought in the best Shawn Rhoden. He wasn't trying to play the size game and none of that stuff. He just came in with quality. So what I'm saying, guys, First of all, I don't think that Phil Heath, his hernia stuff's going to be repaired by next year. Because everybody's like, oh, the only reason Shawn won is because it was through default. Like, he's default Mr. Olympia because Phil Heath was not at his best. And then Kai Greene wasn't there, right? But see, here's the thing, guys. Shawn Rhoden bought his best package for that day. You had Rolly Winkler there. You had all these other guys there, man. And, I mean, they're no slouches, dude. They're high-caliber bodybuilders. That's what I'm saying. Any day, those positions can be changed. So what I wanted to share with you in this video is my belief that if Shawn Rhoden sticks to the same game plan he had for winning this Olympia, you know what I mean? And don't let his travel schedule get in front of him. And, you know, there's the whole, all the appearances that come with being Mr. Olympia. See, that's a whole other side of it. Because he didn't go to the Prague pro show. And he was scheduled to go there. And then he pulled out at the last minute. So, you know, people are speculating why he did that. I just think that, you know, that when you look at Shawn Rhoden, man, the level of preparation that he put into it, dude. When I had to diet down, like, he looked like he barely had any energy at all, like, even to pose. You know, and I think when he carved up his stuff, it gave him a little bit of energy. But when you diet down like that, like the level of dryness he had in his skin, bro, like he dehydrated himself, bro. So I think he just needed some time to recover, man. He's like, fuck that shit. I'm Mr. Olympia, dude. I'm going to recuperate, right? That's my opinion. I wasn't there. But I think overall, like, he's not there. Like, I'll be honest with you guys. I've been to some competitions in judo and full contact karate. And jiu-jitsu, where there was nobody else in my weight class, and so then I won because it's called through default, and then I won some other ones because some guys would drop out of the competition, like maybe they got hurt or something, and then it would be through default. So I don't believe that Shawn Rhoden is Mr. Olympia through default or through forfeit. I believe that he fully believes. I believe that he has brought in the package that bodybuilding as a sport needs, because the bubble gut thing was just getting too out of hand. I think it started with Dave Palumbo and Ronnie Coleman, man. That's what I think. Where you just eat so much food, your gut just gets massive from eating all that food, right? But I think that Shawn Rhoden has brought in a new trend where the pendulum's going to swing back more toward the classic physique. What I mean by that, I'm not talking about the classic physique category, and I'm not trying to be disrespectful to those guys, because I think that's a watered-down physique category. But I understand. I mean, some of those guys have nice physiques, and they're pretty big, but when you're talking about the open Mr. Olympia, it's about, I mean, maybe you're not a mass monster, but you're fucking massive. But at the same time, you got to have the pleasing lines and the flowing physique that tapers down into a really tight midsection, dude. And I think for the last 5 years or so, that's been missing on the Olympia stage. And I think that Shawn Rhoden, through his infinite wisdom working with Chris, they have come up with the ultimate package of, he's got some nice size, but dude, he was ripped, he was conditioned, he had pleasing lines, man. He flowed down like his waist when he hit his abdo waist shots, man. That's pure old school bodybuilding right there. You can call it new school, new jack, whatever, but that's the next evolution of bodybuilding. When you hit the ab shot, your abs are tight. When you transition, your abs are tight. And whatever pose you're in, front, side, or back, your abs are tight. There's no extended gut, right? And then it makes the people feel like you're truly a champion, right? You're not just some drugged up dude, right? Pharmaceutically enhanced, even though that may be the situation, but The gut says a lot, man, about your physique. And I think that Shawn has brought what the judges were looking for, what our sport needed. You know, it's just time. And so when he brought that package, that's why the audience, man, not one person booed when he won, man. Not one person, dude. Like, everybody, you know, everybody applauded. Like, I remember when Kai Greene and Phil Heath used to go out, and they both had, like, extended guts, and Phil Heath would win. Man, almost half of the crowd would boo, man. But not one person booed for Shawn, because, dude, he's got a good package for the future of bodybuilding. The fact that he's 43, Me personally, man, I think that if Shawn Rhoden continues to bring his A game, because if he doesn't bring his A game, you know, he's got the kind of physique where, like, Phil Heath could get away coming in a little bit off, but when Shawn comes in off, it's not Shawn. It's a whole nother, you know what I'm trying to say? It's like a whole nother presentation. That's how drastic it is when he's off. So if he comes in on, I don't believe Phil Heath can beat him or Kai Greene, because they have a different type of a package. He's got the new, improved version with a package that the Mr. Olympia needs, wants, and that what they want to market, because people got tired of the extended gut. And I think that if he comes in with that, you know, like if he comes with the same condition he came this year, the same package, he'll win it. I would say he's going to get at least a four-year run like Jay Cutler, because, you know, he's got age against him, dude, and it's just like what happened with Dorian Yates. You need to get older, you get injuries and stuff. So he's 43. I could see him going 44, 45, and 46. But when you start getting up past 46, man, it's just the nature of your joints and ligaments and stuff. I'm not trying to badmouth him, but that's just my opinion. And so long live Shawn Rhoden. At least get a couple Olympias under your belt. Stick to your own plan, dude. Don't worry about others, and I think you're going to do great. Until next time, OG Silverback, out.